All right, big toes together, knees wide, forehead down. Just take a couple deep breaths here. Settle into that first child's pose. Begin to find your Ujjayi breath, breathing in and out through the nose. Slightly constricting the back of your throat so you can hear the sound of your breath. And make each inhale and exhale a little bit longer. So remember, you can always go at your own pace. If you guys need to modify or skip anything, I know we've got different injuries or issues going on today, that's fine. Listen to your body. That's the most important thing. You can rest in child's pose whenever you need it. Walk your hands over to the right side of the mat, placing the left hand on top of the right so you feel a little stretch through the left side of your body. And walk your hands to the left side, right hand goes on top of the left. Good. Let's bring it to our hands and knees to a tabletop position. Hands right under the shoulders, knees under the hips. Inhale, drop your belly, arch your back, and gaze up, cow pose. Exhale, tuck your chin in, round your back for cat. So just starting to warm up the spine. Inhale as you arch. Exhale as you round. One more time. Inhale to arch. Exhale to round. And after that last one, find a neutral spine right in the middle. Peel your right arm up, thread the needle, thread that right arm through, put your head down, walking that left hand forward, maybe even crawling it a little bit over to the right. Good, back to tabletop, and then we'll switch sides. Peel that left arm up, thread it through, put your head down, walk that right hand forward, and maybe a little to the left. Good, back to your hands and knees, tabletop position. Now, opposite arm and leg, right arm goes forward, left leg goes back, using your core to balance. Exhale, knee to elbow, bring it in. Inhale to extend and reach. Exhale, knee to elbow. Inhale to extend. And one more time. Exhale, knee to elbow. Inhale, extend. Now you can choose to hold it here or bend your leg. Try to grab your foot. Find a little back bend, kicking that foot back. Stretch it out long. Set it down. Switch sides. Left arm, right leg. Exhale, knee to elbow. Inhale to extend. Exhale, knee to elbow. Inhale, extend. One more time. Knee to elbow, then extend it out and either hold or bend your leg, grab your foot, kick it back, find a little back bend. Stretch it out long, place it down, and now we'll come into our first downward facing dog. Plant your hands shoulder width. Tuck your toes, lift your hips up, bend one leg at a time. Walk out your down dog, stretch your calves, hamstrings, maybe bend one elbow at a time. Just kind of check in, see how your body feels. Try to shrug those shoulders away from the ears, press the chest back towards your thighs, pressing the weight towards the heels. It's okay if they don't reach the floor yet. Walk your feet up to meet your hands, ragdoll at the front. Feet hips width, bend your knees a lot, and grab opposite elbows, letting yourself hang. Shaking your head, yes and no, relaxing the neck. Maybe swaying a bit side to side, shifting the body weight from the right foot to the left foot. You can also sway forward and back, shifting from the balls of the feet to the heels. Then roll yourself up to stand, one vertebra at a time. Good. When you get to the top, lift your arms up. Your right hand is going to grab your left wrist and pull it to the right, creating a side body stretch. And switch, grab your right wrist, pull it over to the left. Nice. Back to center. Interlace your fingers behind your back. Or use your strap, open up the chest, bend your knees, Fold forward with the hands interlaced. Now release the hands down. We're gonna cross the feet. So we'll take that right foot, cross it behind the left foot and fold over your legs. Now we're still warming up. Feel free to bend the knees as much as you need to or put your hands on blocks. If your legs are straight and you wanna add on, walk your hands to the left edge of the mat. Walk your hands to center, switch the cross of the feet. So now the right foot is in front, folding forward, maybe walking it to the right side of your mat. Now walk your hands to center, uncross the feet. Inhale, lengthen your spine to a flat back. As you exhale, plant the hands, step to plank. We're gonna modify the first chaturanga by placing the knees on the floor. Hug your elbows in and slowly lower all the way to your belly. Untuck the toes so the tops of the feet press down. Cobra pose, just a small back bend, lifting the chest, lower down. Push up to your knees to that modified plank. Tuck your toes under and come back to down dog. Now, as we move, right, you can always go back to that version, or if you need to skip any of the vinyasas, just go straight to down dog. Look forward, step, or you can hop both feet up to meet your hands. Inhale, lengthen your spine to a flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Now use your flat back. Inhale, reverse swan dive all the way up to stand. Gaze up, maybe those palms touch. Then exhale, swan dive right back down. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, plant the hands, step to plank. Now you choose from the toes or the knees, chaturanga, you lower halfway and hug the elbows in. Flip over the feet, inhale, up dog, or stay with your cobra. If you're an up dog, just the tops of the feet and the hands on the floor, engage those legs. Good, exhale, flip back over one at a time, down dog. Look forward, step or hop your feet back up to your hands. Feet together. Inhale, lengthen, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. One more time. Inhale, reverse swan dive all the way up to stand. Gaze up at your palms. Exhale, swan dive right back down. Inhale, lengthen. Then exhale, you can step or hop back, chaturanga, from the toes or the knees. Inhale to your up dog or your cobra, finding your back bend. Exhale, down dog. Now in your down dog, lift the right leg up, open the hip and bend the leg. Maybe draw a couple circles with the leg or the ankle, or just get a nice stretch there. Step your right foot between your hands for a low lunge. Put your left knee down. Untuck the toes, start with your hands on that right thigh. Make sure your right knee is directly over your ankle. If you'd like to add a little back bend, lift your arms up, gaze up. Maybe press the palms together overhead. Bring your hands to heart center to prayer position. Twist your left elbow outside the right leg, actively pressing into your palms, working your hands towards the center of your chest. Lower your hands now to the floor or blocks, framing that front foot. Half split, straighten your right leg, flex the foot. Make sure your hip is over your knee, you're not sitting on that back foot. And then fold towards the right leg, checking in with that right hamstring and calf. Good, rebend the leg, just go straight back to down dog. Plant your hands, step back, reset, downward facing dog. Then lift the left leg up, open the hip, bend the leg. Just on this first one, create a nice stretch, maybe draw some circles, move it around. Step your left foot between your hands, low lunge, put that right knee down. Make sure the knee's over the ankle and start with the hands on that left side. Sinking into that right hip flexor. Maybe you add the arms, adding a little back bend, gazing up. Hands can be shoulder width, or you can try pressing the palms together.
Lower your hands to heart center. Twist right elbow outside the left leg, pressing your hands towards the center of your chest. Lower your hands to the floor or the blocks, framing that foot. Half split, straightening the left leg. Flex your left foot and then fold, bringing your nose towards your left leg. Rebend the leg, bring your hands to the floor. Step your way back to down dog. Reset in your downward facing dog. Look forward, step or hop, both feet up to meet your hands. Inhale, lengthen, flat back. Exhale to fold. Make sure your feet are all the way together. Bend your knees, Utkatasana, chair pose. Lift the arms up, knees and feet together. As you look down, you should be able to see all 10 toes. Sit a little lower. Hold the legs in this chair position. Twist your left arm forward, right arm back. So you have an open twist from your waist. Both arms back up to chair. Twist the other way. Right arm forward, left arm back. Good. Both arms back up. Interlace your hands behind your lower back. The awkward way, the other thumb on top. And then fold forward, maybe straightening the legs. Release your hands down. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, you can step or hop back. Chaturanga, low push-up. Elbows in. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale to downward facing dog. Lift your right leg up. Step it between your hands. This time coming into crescent lunge, staying on the ball of your back foot as you lift your arms up. High crescent lunge. Your back heel is lifted, hips are square to the front. Now, just like you did in chair, we'll find that open twist, left arm forward, right arm back, twisting from your waist. Inhale, the arms back up, press and lunge. Exhale, warrior two, pivot your back heel down so your back foot is parallel to the back edge of the mat. Keep that big bend in your right leg. Gaze at your right hand and flip that right palm up to the ceiling. Put your left hand on the left thigh, reverse warrior. Reach that right arm back. Then windmill the hands down to the front. Step back, chaturanga, low push-up. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Lift the left leg up, step it between your hands. Setting up crescent lunge, start on the ball of the back foot. Lift your arms up, hips square to the front. Twisting from your waist, right arm forward, left arm back, open twist. Both arms back up, crescent lunge. Open to warrior two, pivot your back heel flat on the ground, open the hips, arms out like a T. Gaze at your left hand and flip that palm up. Inhale, reverse warrior, reach back, stretch the side body. Exhale, windmill, down to the front and step right back. Chaturanga, low push-up. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Looking forward, step or hop, both feet up to meet your hands. Inhale, lengthen, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Bend your knees, coming back to our chair pose, Utkatasana. Now sit low, bring your hands to prayer. Twist your left elbow outside the right leg. Keep those knees together and then press into your palms. Now you have two options with the arms. You can keep the hands in prayer or you can open the arms, putting your left fingertips on the floor or block, but keeping that tricep on the outside of the leg as you peel that right arm up. Fold forward, separate your feet, hips width distance apart. Padagustasana, your peace fingers, grab your big toes. Bend the knees as much as you need to hold your big toes. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold. Drop your head, relax your neck, stretch through the hamstrings. Release the toes, walk your feet back together. We're gonna go to the other side. So feet together, bend your knees, Utkatasana, chair pose. Hands to prayer, sit low. Twist, right elbow outside the left leg. Don't let one knee sneak in front of the other. Keep them right next to each other. You can hold it here or maybe work on opening the arms, right fingertips to the floor or block and twisting that left arm up. And fold forward. This time, take your feet all the way to the edges of the mat, Malasana, prayer squat. Turn your toes out, 45 degrees. Drop your hips down, hands to prayer. Use your elbows, push the hips, inner thighs open. If your heels are not flat on the ground, take your feet a little wider apart. Press the chest forward, lengthen your spine. You can hold it here or we'll open the arms by sliding the right shoulder inside the right knee. Right hand down, left arm up and gaze up. Back to center and go the other way. Left hand down, right arm up. And back to center. Now we'll play with crow pose. If you want to skip it, you can just meet us in child's pose or ragdoll. But if you're coming to crow, walk your feet together. Hands are going to go shoulder width. Bend your arms just a little bit. Put your knees up high on those triceps. And then use them as a little shelf. Lean forward. Keep looking forward. Don't look at your feet. Look past the edge of the mat. Maybe lift one or both feet off of the ground. Bakasana, crow pose. Good. Feel free to play with it. You can come to child's pose when you've had enough of your crow. Okay. Reset in your child's pose. Reconnect to your breath. Check in here. And let's come back to downward facing dog. Lift the right leg up, step it between your hands, crescent lunge. So you're on the ball of your back foot. Make sure your feet are lined up with your hips so you feel balanced. Hands to prayer, twist left elbow outside the right leg. Now you can always go back to that low lunge that we did earlier by putting the back knee down if you want. You can keep your hands in prayer. You can also open the arms. Left hand down, right arm up. You can use the block anytime your hand doesn't reach the floor. Engage your legs, come back up to crescent, lift the arms back up. Look down at the floor and come into airplane. Sweep your arms back, your palms will face down. Square your hips, flex that left foot. Standing splits, hands now lower to the floor or to the blocks. Lift that left leg higher without opening the hip and bring your nose towards your knee or your shin. Maybe even that right hand might grab the back of that right ankle. Now let's lower the leg just a little bit and flex the foot. Try to get it parallel to the floor. Come up to your fingertips and lengthen your spine. Left hand is going to stay down on the floor or the block. Twist your right arm up for revolved half moon. Parvrita Ardha Chandrasana. You can gaze down, side, or up. Looking up is always the most challenging for the balance. So if you're having a hard time balancing, keep your eyes on the floor. You're twisting from your waist. Good. Lower the hand down carefully from here. Just step back to crescent lunge. Set the ball of the foot down first. Then lift your arms up. High crescent lunge. Open to warrior two, pivot that back heel down. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Exhale, modified or extended side angle. Right elbow to the thigh or right hand to the floor, block on the inside of the foot. Left arm can be up to the ceiling or you can reach it forward, palm facing down for that extended side angle. Lift back up, warrior two. Inhale as you reverse. Exhale, windmill the hands down to the front. Step back, chaturanga, low push-up. Inhale, up dog or cobra.
Exhale, down dog. Take a couple deep breaths, reset here before we do that whole sequence on the other side. Lift the left leg up, step it between your hands, crescent lunge, Anjaneyasana, on the ball of the back foot, find your balance. Hands come to prayer position, twist right elbow outside the left leg. Again, you can engage that back leg and keep the knee off of the floor, or you can set that knee back down. Then if you want to open the arms, right hand on the floor block and peel that left arm up to twist. Carefully come back up, crescent lunge. Focus your eyes, airplane, Degasana. Sweep your arms back, palms face the floor, lifting that right leg, keeping those hips level and square. Standing splits, put your hands on the floor or the blocks, and then as you lift that leg higher, try to bring your nose closer to your left leg. If you want to grab the ankle, left hand to the back of that ankle. Now lower your leg a little bit so it's about parallel to the floor. Flex your foot. Come up to your fingertips and really lengthen the spine. And don't be afraid to grab your blocks if you have them. Right hand on the floor, block closer to the right corner of the mat. Not by your foot, over by the corner of the mat. Then twist that left arm up. Revolved half moon, Parvrita Ardha Chandrasana. Try to extend both legs straight. Flex that foot. It's the twisted version of half moon. Nice. Now put your hand down first, then carefully step back to your crescent lunge. Reset the feet, adjust them if you need to, and lift your arms up. Crescent lunge. Open warrior two, Virabhadrasana B, pivoting that back heel down. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Exhale, modified or extended side angle. Left elbow to the thigh or left hand on the floor block. And then that right arm, you can either keep it straight up to the ceiling or reach it over your ear, palm facing down, bicep by your ear. Lift back up, warrior two. Inhale to reverse your warrior. Exhale, windmill the hands down to the front. Step back, chaturanga, low push up. Inhale, up dog. Exhale to down dog. Now lifting the right leg up, step it to the outside of your right hand and put your left knee on the floor. So before we come down to regular lizard, turn your right foot out to the side, 45 degrees. Plant your left hand down and twist your right hand back. You can just hold with that twist or maybe grab your left foot with the right hand and stretch your quad, pulling that heel in towards you. Let go of the foot if you're holding it. Now, return those right toes straight forward. Okay, so toes forward, foot at the edge of the mat, knee over the ankle, both hands on the inside of the foot. Maybe come down to your elbows for lizard or use your blocks. Or again, maybe one elbow. Just get as low as you can on this side. Press up to your hands, just go to down dog. No chaturanga, straight back, reset in your down dog. Lift the left leg up, step it outside the left hand and put your right knee down. For the first variation, we turn the left foot out 45 degrees. Then we put the right hand directly down below us, twist the left arm back. You can hold it there, still a good hip opening, or bend that right leg, grab the foot with the left hand and pull it in towards you, stretching the quad of the back leg.
Let go of the foot, then readjust your left toes to point straight forward. Knee over ankle, all five toes forward. Hands, elbows, or blocks on the inside of that left foot for lizard pose, opening up that left hip. Press up to your hands, and then we'll go back to down dog. Step back, reset, downward facing dog. Lift the right leg up. Step it forward between your hands for crescent lunge, Anjaneyasana on the ball of that back foot. Then right away, we'll open to our warrior two, Virabhadrasana B, pivoting that back heel down. Inhale, reverse. Exhale into half moon, Ardha Chandrasana, regular half moon now. So right hand to the floor block, 6 to 8 inches in front of that right baby toe, closer to the corner of the mat. Flex that left foot and keep your hip open for this one. So regular half moon, very different from the twisted version where the hip was square and we were twisting. But here, everything is facing that side wall. Step back, warrior two. Straighten your right leg. Walk your left foot in just 1 or 2 inches, heading up for triangle. Shift the hips back, both legs are straight. Reach forward, right hand on the shin, ankle, or foot. Left arm up to the ceiling, Trikonasana. Create that length in your spine, that length in both sides of the waist. Use your core, lift your torso back up. Then come back to warrior two. You have to adjust the feet, walk your back foot out, rebend that right leg. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, windmill the hands down and step back. Chaturanga, low push up. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Lift the left leg up, step it forward. Last time, crescent lunge. Start on the ball of that back foot as you lift the arms up. And then we open to our warrior two, Virabhadrasana B. Inhale as you reverse. Exhale into half moon, Ardha Chandrasana. Left fingertips 6 to 8 inches in front of that left baby toe. Flex that right foot. Peel that hip open here. Bend your standing leg. Step back, warrior two. Reset the feet first. Then straighten your front leg, bring your back foot in 1 or 2 inches, shift the hips back, reach forward till you can't reach anymore, and set the hand down, shin, ankle, or foot. Right arm straight up to the ceiling, Trikonasana, triangle pose. Use your core, lift back up to stand. Now come back to warrior two. Walk your right foot out. Rebend that front leg. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, windmill the hands down and step back. Chaturanga, low push up. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, down dog. Step or hop, both feet to the front and roll up to stand. Now we're going to face the long side of your mat, whichever side you want to face. Separate your feet. Feet are parallel. Interlace the fingers together behind your back or use your strap. Open up the chest and then fold forward, keeping the hands interlaced. Just drop your head, relax your neck. Straddle forward, fold with the fingers interlaced. Release your hands and walk your hands through your legs. So now just crawl them through a little bit further. Now walk both hands over to the left leg, grab your ankle or calf, pull your nose closer to the left leg.
Walk your hands over to the right leg. Pull your nose closer to the right leg. Bring it to center. Find a flat back. Place your right hand down directly under your nose on the floor block and twist and peel that left arm up to the ceiling. And switch. Place the left hand down, twist, peel that right arm up. Good. Both hands down. Bend your knees. Hands to hips. Take your time. Slowly stand up. Good, step to the front. Now, before we do grasshopper, we're gonna do standing number four by itself because that's our prep pose and gonna help us when we get to grasshopper. So let me step back so you can see, hands to prayer. Take your right foot across, make a number four with your legs. Flex your right foot, bend your left leg like you're sitting back into a chair. Try to bring your elbows on the shin there or maybe fingertips or hands to the floor. But the more you bend the left leg, the deeper the stretch you're gonna feel in that right hip. And for now, no arm balances, just hold it. Come up, shake it out, switch legs, and try the other side. Standing number four, just to open the hip, flex your left foot, bend your right standing leg, and sit those hips back. Hands can stay in prayer, or you can try to work your hands down closer to the floor. Come up, shake it out. Now, you guys can watch me first. For grasshopper, I'm gonna give you a lot of stages, and really, you can't move on to the next stage, right, until you master the stage you're in. So it starts with that same number four, but now we're gonna add a twist, okay? So we've done a lot of twisting. It's gonna be same elbow to foot, right elbow to right foot or left elbow to left foot. So I have my right foot across. So I'm gonna try to twist my right elbow into the sole of my foot. Now, this is the first part. So if you can't even get your elbow there, that's okay. You're just gonna work that. You might be here. You might start to inch it closer. Now, I like to keep my eyes on the floor for balance, and then I'm equally pushing my foot and elbow into each other, and I get a really nice stretch in my hip and my upper back here. Now, the next step, if you get here, I like to take my left hand and hold onto my right foot so it doesn't go anywhere, slide it higher up my arm, and put my right hand down and my left arm up. The foot, the higher up I get it, the closer to my armpit, just like with crow, the easier it's gonna be. Right fingertips can be on the floor, and then the left arm goes up. Now, if you get there, then the next step is for the arm balance. I keep my right hand down. I'm gonna have to lean over a little bit to get this left hand to the floor. My arms are like chaturanga, they're bent. I wiggle my left foot to the side until I feel I can lift it, flex my foot, and kick that left foot straight forward. And I'm looking at my left foot. I'm looking to the side. It's easier for balance. Plus, I don't accidentally crush my nose on the floor. So that's grasshopper. So again, it requires a lot of twisting, a lot of hip opening. I'll show you one more time. I'll do the other side so that way I can even it out and then I'll let you guys play with it. So again, I start with number four. Step one is just the twist. Maybe you're here, maybe you're here, maybe you can get that elbow into the foot and you might find one side is different. So it's important to try both sides. Now, if I get the elbow to the foot, I'm gonna take my right hand, hold my left foot in place and slide that foot up higher. So I can get my left hand or fingertips to the floor and maybe twist the right arm up and stay there, right? Just like our chair twist, but with a number four. Or I kind of have to fall into it. Put both hands down, shoulders with distance, walk my right foot. See, I'm kind of just inching it to the side. Both feet are flexed. So the foot on my tricep is like standing on my arm. My other foot is flexed, I look to the side. Questions? I know it's a little bit of an advanced pose, but you guys can handle it. So let's try it. Take your time. Start one step at a time. Start with number four. If you felt when we did the number four the first time that one hip was a little bit more flexible, start with that side because it will be easier. Then twist. If your right foot's across, right elbow to right foot. If it's your left foot, it's your left elbow to your left foot. If you get that twist, then you open the arms. Erica, twist the other way.
But don't force it. Again, if it doesn't feel good today, it's okay. But if your right foot's across, your right elbow goes to your right foot. All right, let's see. Yep, that's it, Melanie. Good. Good. Now, again, you got to walk the foot up the tricep. If it's too close to the elbow, when you go for those arm balances, your foot will slip off. Nice, Gus. Flex your foot. There you go. That's it. Good. Notice your foot slipping just a little bit. So try to keep it up higher on the tricep in that initial setup. Right? So that's why I like to use my hand. I really hug that heel, and then I work that foot up higher on the arm. Try both sides, whichever variation you're doing, right? Even if you're not doing the full arm balance, make sure you even it out. You do the twist on both sides, see how far you can go. Notice if one side is a little bit more open than the other. Good, Sydney, that's the right idea. That's how you set it up. Good, Michaela. Now just lift that foot, that's it. Nice, you had it, nice. Good, you guys. If you're done, you can meet in child's pose. If you want to try it one more time, right? Try it one more time. It's definitely one of those poses that you got to keep coming back to, right? Keep playing with it. But it's one of those poses you do need to be warmed up for, right? Like there are some poses I'm like, oh, you could just throw it here and there and do it whenever. But this one you definitely have to be pretty warmed up for. So let's reset in our child's pose. And maybe in this variation, you bring your knees together if that feels good. You can bring your forehead down and take your arms alongside you so that your shoulders can really relax. And take a few deep breaths there. When you're ready, coming back to your downward facing dog for a moment, reset, check in with your down dog. Step your feet to the front of the mat and just roll up to stand, one vertebra at a time. So for today's standing balance, we're gonna do dancer pose because we haven't done a lot of back bends, but I want us to start to move into our back bending part of the class. So left arm will reach up, right hand can grab your right foot or your ankle, and you can go inside or outside, whatever feels more comfortable. Focus your gaze and then kick that right leg up, not Chaturanjasana, dancer pose. Finding your balance as well as that back bend. Release and switch sides. So right arm lifts up, left hand to the foot or ankle. Start with the knees together, get your balance first, focus your gaze, and then start to lift that leg up for that back bend. Nice, let's release. Meet at the top of the mat, feet together, hands to prayer position, reset. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale to a flat back. As you exhale, step to plank, and then we're gonna come all the way down to the floor. So you'll lower all the way down. Forehead down, arms by your side, like airplane arms, palms pressing down. Squeeze your legs together and lift everything up. Arms, legs, chest, legs. Good, lift a little higher, keep your gaze down. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Release, let one ear come to the floor, just relax. Now you can repeat that or add on by interlacing the fingers. Bring your forehead down, squeeze the legs together, and then lift back up, lifting the hands away from the tailbone. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Release, other ear to the mat. Now again, you can repeat either of those two, or last back bend for today will be bow pose, Dhanurasana. Bend your legs, grab the outside of your ankles, knees about hips width, and then really kick through the legs to lift the chest. So try to push your quads onto the floor, but kick your shin bones back. Yes, hold. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now release, let go of the feet, keep your knees bent. Windshield wiper your shins side to side to gently release the lower back. And then we'll press back to a child's pose and reset your spine. Meeting in downward facing dog, we'll be setting up for a half pigeon. If it bothers your knee and you need to modify your half pigeon today, you can lay on your back for a lying down version of number four.
Kind of like what we did standing, but you can lay down for that figure four stretch. If you're doing half pigeon, lift the right leg up, bend the knee, bring it forward, put your right knee behind your right wrist.
Straighten out that left leg, square your hips. Your knee is in line with your hip, not your belly button, not off of your mat, right? Directly in line with the hip. If this feels good, you fold forward. If your hips are on the floor, you wanna move that shin a little bit, you can move it forward, but no further than creating a 90 degree angle in that knee with the shin parallel to the front. If you do start to move that shin away from you, make sure you flex the foot, okay? Then once you get everything set up that feels good, you fold forward. You can use blocks under your forehead or your hip if you need to, or again, remember, you always have that option to lay on your back for that lying down number four. It still stretches the hip the same way. Let's lock the hands in. If you're on your back, hug your knees into your chest. If you're in half pigeon, lift that right leg back up to a three-legged down dog. Maybe open the hip like we did at the beginning of class. You can draw a few circles or move it around. And then we'll meet in down dog to reset. If you're on your back, switch your legs for that lying down number four stretch. If you're doing pigeon, lift the left leg up and then bring that left knee forward. So the left knee should go behind the wrist and slide that right leg back and square your hips. And again, you can keep this foot close to you. For most people, that's a good stretch. You just fold forward there. If your hips are feeling pretty flexible and you want to go deeper, you move that shin more forward. But you should never feel pain in this knee. Okay? If you feel pain in the knee, you need to bring that foot back in. Mostly you should feel that stretch in the left outer hip. Sometimes you'll feel in the inner thigh of that leg or the hip flexor of the back leg. That's okay too. Flex the foot and then fold forward. Again, grab any props if you need them, right? You can use blocks, blankets, pillows, whatever you've got. It's always okay to add those in. Walk your hands in, last down dog. If you're on your back, you can stay on your back and hug your knees in. If you're coming to that down dog, maybe shake out that left leg, move it around, and then just kind of check in and see how your last down dog feels. And wherever you're at, we're all gonna meet in a seated position and find our straddle splits. So face whatever way you have enough space, wiggle your legs apart. Flex your feet, right hand over to that right leg or foot, and reach the left arm over your ear, creating that side body stretch. Good Then take it to the opposite side, all the way up and over. Good, come up, keep the feet flexed, and walk your hands forward and fold as far as you can, keeping those toes going straight up to the ceiling. Walk your hands in, carefully shake out your legs, bring them together, facing the front. Legs all the way together, flex the feet, sit up nice and tall, and fold forward. Paschimottanasana, seated forward fold. You can use your strap if you can't grab the feet, or you can always just grab your legs too, wherever you can reach. Keep those feet flexed though, it'll give you a better stretch to the backs of the legs. Slowly come up, roll all the way down onto your back. Bend your knees, place your feet on the floor. Open your arms out to the side like a T. Cross the right leg over the left, stack the knees. Move your hips an inch or two to the right and then drop your knees to the left. If you don't like crossing the legs, you can also uncross them and just drop both knees to the left. Maybe turn your gaze to the right. Or you can just keep your head neutral. If it bothers you to move your neck, just keep your eyes straight up to the ceiling. Bring it back to center and switch the cross of the legs. The left leg crosses over the right. Move your hips an inch or two to the left and then drop your knees to the right. Maybe turning the gaze to the left or keeping your head center. Taking that twist to the other side. Let's bring everything back to center. Uncross the legs. Wrap your arms around your shins. Give yourself a big hug, curling up into a little ball. And then letting everything go as you come into your Shavasana. Final relaxation. Extending the legs long, letting the feet fall open. Arms relaxing alongside you, palms facing up. Take your shoulders, shrug them away from the ears to help keep the neck long. And as you close your eyes, clear away any last remaining thoughts. Take a nice deep inhale through your nose. Exhale all the air out the mouth, letting it go, letting your muscles relax deeper into the floor.
Slowly begin to wiggle your fingers and your toes. Bring some small movements back to your body. And maybe draw a few circles with the wrists and ankles, moving them in both directions. Maybe gently moving the head side to side. Anything that feels good to you. When you feel ready, we'll reach those arms overhead, reach the legs long, and create that nice full body stretch here, getting as tall as you can. Hug your knees into your chest. Roll over to one side, coming into a fetal position. Keep your eyes closed. Use the hands to help press you up into a comfortable seated position. Crossing the legs, sitting up nice and tall. Bringing your hands together at heart center, Anjali Mudra. And take a couple last deep breaths. Scanning the body, noticing how it feels after your yoga practice today. Take a nice deep inhale through your nose. And then exhale all the air out the mouth, letting it go. Lifting your hands to your forehead, your third eye center, and bowing forward.
Namaste.